Hello friends, welcome to the EduSite Network. Our today's topic of discussion is monetary and fiscal policy of India, and this is part of our series on macroeconomics. And for this discussion, we have with us in our studio our subject expert, Dr. Rajiv Shukla. He is the PhD coordinator at the Indian Institute of Foreign Trade, New Delhi, and I welcome him to our EduSite Network. Thank you, sir, and I request you to begin our today's lecture.
Hello friends, yesterday we had discussed about the macro, under the macroeconomic series, ki what is the meaning of constructed GDP, GNP, NNP. We had earlier discussed about the some macroeconomic policies and concept. We have also discussed about the problem which consists of fluctuation of market and how it resolves. As yesterday lecture we had discussed what is the difference between classical economics opinion and the Keynesian economics opinion. Today we are going to discuss a very important factor of our economy. You can say it's a base of your economy. With the help of these two policies, you can regulate, you can generate, and you can accumulate whole of the economy in India or either any of our country. The monetary and the fiscal policy are one of the two measures, a very important measures who can regulate the Indian economy or any world economy. So let's begin with monetary policy. Just name suggests, what is the meaning of monetary policy? As the name indicate, monetary, it's a very much related to money. So one of the definition is here, is here on your slides, which is states by Reserve Bank of India, that monetary policy refers to the use of instruments under the control of the central bank to regulate the availability, cost, and use of money and credit. It simply means when your market get fluctuated, when your market get consumed with the inflation or the recession, then the monetary policy with the help of their instrument can the control of the, with the help of central bank, to regulate the availability, cost, and use of money and credit. The monetary and credit policy is the policy statement traditionally announced twice a year, through which the Reserve Bank of India seeks to ensure price stability for the economy. As I said, when your economy get fluctuated, either the recession is in economy or the inflation is in economy, so with the help of monetary policy, RBI assured that sometimes of policy implement, sometimes of instrument applies under the monetary policy, they are tried and they will try to regulate of our economy. As these factor includes money supply, interest rate, and the inflation. In banking and economics terms, money supply is referred to as M3. It's M1, M2, and M3. So this is consist of M3, which indicates the level of legal currency in the economy. Besides, the RBI also announced norms for the banking and financial sector and the institution which are governed by it. These are two types of measures which are going to explore in next one slides. So here, when your economy is in a trouble, either if the more inflation or the inflation or the more recession or recession, then with the help of these measures, these instrument RBI applied some possible and a fruitful implementation to regulate our economy. Importance of monetary policy. How is it so important in point of our economy? As I said, ki there are so much instrument used by Reserve Bank under monetary policy, and with the help of these instrument, Reserve Bank trying to regulate of our economy. In the present scenario, most of the guys are seeing that it's a inflation scene. So how can monetary policy to get resolved this type of inflation which we are facing in present scenario? In terms of importance, we can say Yeah, we had discussed earlier gross national product GNP. Everybody knows who are viewed the last lectures. C plus I plus G plus X, where C for private consumption expenditure, I for private investment expenditure, Z for government expenditure, and X is equal to net exports. And CIX can be influenced by the monetary policy. These are the basic features which are regulate our economy, which are the part of our economy, and they can be influenced by the monetary policy, which can also influence the private consumption and investment spending, export and import. As you see, C is equal to private consumption expenditure, I private investment expenditure, G government expenditure, X net exports, not only export, net exports. So, if you can say ki how the monetary policy deals with the four of the objective and how can these influenced by the monetary policy? Yes, monetary policy can be influenced by four of all factors. With the help of monetary policy, you can apply it some of the force to regulate the consumption, to enhance the investment, to reduce or the increase government expenditure as per the scenario in your economy, and you have to follow some implications and steps to increase your net export ratio. And all things are governed by RBI, and the policy is called monetary policy. What are the objectives of the monetary policy? As I said, ki when you are in our economy and we are facing some types of trouble in terms of inflation or recession, now the monetary policy introduced, now the monetary policy implementations, some of the steps followed by RBI, when applied RBI, these types of instrument, why they applied, what are the necessity to apply it for these steps, and what are the objectives of the monetary policy to work? The objectives are maintaining price stability. When your price fluctuation, market fluctuation, to monetary policy, with the help of monetary policy, we can maintain price stability. The second one objective, ensuring adequate flow of credit to the productive sectors of the economy to support economic growth. Third one, rapid economic growth, balance of payment equilibrium, full employment, equal income distribution. These are the basic objectives of our monetary policy, and with the help of monetary policy, we can regulate these factors, and if we can regulate these factors, our economy is in fine positions. The first one is maintaining price stability. When your price gets fluctuated, either is the increase or the decrease, with the help of monetary policy, we can regulate, we can change the fluctuation, we can resolve the fluctuation. The second one, ensuring adequate flow of credit to the productive sector. Sometimes the credit goes to unproductive sectors. Therefore, there is no use to get the credit and to imply all the loans and all the credit to unproductive sector because there is no gain. If your credit implies in productive sector, then your the income, then your output of the country is also increased. So, with the help of monetary policy, we can try ensuring adequate flow to credit, all the credit to the productive sector, not in unproductive sector. Rapid economic growth, we have also tried with the help of monetary policy, and the RBI is always seek to imply them with the instrument of monetary policy to achieve a rapid economic growth. In the same pattern, balance of payment equilibrium. All of guys are very well aware about the balance of payment, credit and debit sectors. So, with the help of monetary policy, we can also regulate the balance of payment. Full employment. RBI tries to get the full employment level with the help of instrument of monetary policy, and the equal income distribution. It's a very real fact. Equal income distribution. India is facing a basic situation that there is no equal income distribution, and that's why some of the person is more rich एंड सम ऑफ द पर्सन इज मोर पुअर, जहां ज्यादा गरीब है बहुत गरीब है, और अगर बहुत रिच है तो बहुत ज्यादा रिच है. मीडियम पर्सनालिटीज जो है वो अलग है, लेकिन इसके अलावा जो वर्ग बन जाते हैं वो काफी है. सो वाई दीज सब ग्रुप्स क्रिएटेड विद बिकॉज ऑफ नॉन इक्वल इनकम डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी इंप्लीमेंटेशन वी कैन ट्राई एंड वी कैन रेगुलेट दिस टाइप ऑफ सब ग्रुप्स, वी कैन रिजोल्व द सब ग्रुप्स एंड वी आर ट्राइंग टू इक्वल इनकम डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी. मैथड्स, वट आर द मैथड्स अप्लाई बाई आरबीआई? द आरबीआई एम्स टू अचीव इट्स ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ एंड कंट्रोल ऑफ इन्फ्लेशन थ्रू वेरियस मैथड्स. एज वी डिस्कस अबाउट द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स वर्ड, सो नाउ वी कैन एक्सप्लोर वट आर द इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स आर अप्लाइंग एंड आर अप्लाइड एंड वील अप्लाई बाई आरबीआई टू रेगुलेट ऑल ऑफ योर ऑब्जेक्टिव और टू अचीव ऑल ऑफ योर ऑब्जेक्टिव्स. दीज मैथड्स कैन बी ग्रुप्ड एज जनरली ऑब्लिक क्वांटिटेटिव मैथड, सेलेक्टिव ऑफ द क्वालिटेटिव मैथड. यू कैन से इज ओनली अ क्वांटिटेटिव मैथड एंड क्वालिटेटिव मैथड. देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ मैथड विच आर बी अप्लाइज अंडर मॉनिटरी पॉलिसी इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. फर्स्ट वन वी कैन क्वांटिटेटिव मेजर्स. देर आर फोर मेजर्स. फर्स्ट वन इज बैंक रेट, ओपन मार्केट ऑपरेशंस, कैश रिजर्व रेशियो, स्टैचुरी लिक्विडिटी रेशियो विच इज कॉल्ड SLR आल्सो, एंड द कैश रिजर्व रेशियो इज CRR. एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द गाइज आर वेरी मच हर्ड अबाउट दिस, एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द गाइज हैव आल्सो सीन इन अवर न्यूज पेपर्स मैगजीन्स द वर्ड CRR एंड द वर्ड इज SLR. समटाइम्स यू हैव हर्ड अबाउट द बैंक रेट, दैट द RBI had decreased bank rate or the increased bank rate. Why RBI applies these types of steps? Because to regulate our economy, to resolve the fluctuation of economy and to achieve an objective of monetary policy. When you facing, as he begins with bank rate, then you find what is the meaning of bank rate. Bank rate is also known as discount rate. It is a rate at which RBI lends to commercial banks or rediscount their bills. So bank rate is not a rate which is commercial bank generated, or we can take loan from commercial bank or the rate. No, bank rate is also known as discount rate. It is a rate at which RBI lends to the commercial banks, not we are lending to or we lend to commercial banks. RBI lends to commercial banks or rediscount their bills. If the bank rate is increased, then commercial bank also change higher rate of interest on loan gives by banks to public, because now commercial banks get funds from RBI at higher rate of interest, and higher rate of interest will contract credit in the economy. Again, I will try to describe this fact that bank rate is not a normal rate which we lends to commercial bank, because the bank rate is also known as discount rate, and it is the rate at which RBI lends to commercial banks. RBI jis dar se commercial bank ko loan deti hai, because all the commercial banks lending some of type of loans and heavy loans from the RBI, and RBI lends to the commercial bank on a particular rate. This is called a bank rate. So if bank rate is increased, अगर bank rate को बढ़ा दिया जाता है, then commercial bank also charge higher rate. अगर bank rate को RBI बढ़ा देता है, तो जिस तरीके से हम commercial bank से loan लेते हैं, when we lend to loans from commercial bank, and if the commercial banks rise the interest rate, then we are not ready to take a more loan. At the same time, when the RBI revise the bank rate or the increase the bank rates, then the commercial banks also charge higher rate on loaning. So ye kehna ki commercial bank thoda hatosait hote hain loan lene mein, kyunki unke paas jo loaning ke liye paisa hai uska bahut bada hissa interest rate ke taur par RBI ko dena hota hai. Suppose if the commercial bank lends 100 rupees from RBI and the bank rate is 6%, now the 6% is minus from the total money of loan. and they have only loan amount is near about a 94, and they are only they have this is the only amount which they lend to public commercial banks. So when the rate is increased, is the bank rate increased, that means commercial bank also charge higher rate of interest on loan given by bank to public, because now commercial banks get funds from RBI at higher rate. Higher rate of interest will contract credit in the economy. Public will take lesser loans because of higher rate of interest. In other words, you can say it is the interest which is fixed by the RBI to control the lending capacity of commercial bank. In inflation scenario, if we are facing an inflation, agar hum teji ke daur mein hai, to commercial bank ko jo bank rate se loan milta hai from the side of RBI can increase the bank rate to control the credit capacity of commercial banks. Agar wo increase kar deti hai bank rate, to commercial banks ke paas loaning capacity ya loaning ke liye jo fund hai wo kam reh jata hai, aur market mein paisa jyada loan ke roop mein nahi aata hai. That is means the commercial bank is not ready to take lending more money into hand of public because of the higher rate of bank rate, because they are paying a higher interest rate to RBI. So during inflation, RBI increases the bank rate of interest, due to which borrowing power of commercial banks reduces, which thereby reduces the supply of money or credit in the economy. When money supply reduces, it reduces the purchasing power, and thereby curtailing consumption and lowering prices. So this is the definition, this is the meaning of bank rates. There is no contradictory about the interest rate commercial bank which lends to public. This is a very much differentiate from the interest rate of commercial bank which we can take from the loans of commercial bank over interest rate, and the commercial bank take the loan from RBI on bank rate. Here is a slide where you can say a past record of bank rate. Over this slide you can see from the 2 January 19 to 15 July 2013. If you can see, the 15 July 2013 is the bank rate is 10.25, and from the start version, if you can say 2nd January of 1900 is only a 1%, and the scene is, if you can look over this from the side of 1991, 4th July 1991, the bank rate is 11. Now the bank rate is reduces 10, 9, 7, 7, 8, 7, 5. There are some fluctuation from 6, 9, 9, 8, 7, 5. These fluctuation in bank rate shows, if, as I said, if the bank rate is increased, that means inflation is in economy. If you can see any of the year, suppose we can randomly choose 22nd of October 1997, which is 9%. That means at that time inflation was there, because the highs, because the rise of bank rate. If you can choose a lower one, suppose 6.25 in October 2002, then you can say the inflation is not a quite, you can say it's an inflation, but it's not in a trouble scene, because the bank rate is 6.25. But now in a coming, in a previous year, if you can say the bank rate is 10.25, everybody knows ki we were facing inflation in the previous year. So the bank rate is quite increase. RBI increased the bank rate to cut the credibility or the loaning capacity of commercial bank because of inflation. So these sheets shows the fluctuation or the rates of bank rate year wise year. The second portion is the CRR. It's a very much important factor of monetary instruments, and RBI applies more many of times to regulate our economy, to reduce the capability, to reduce the loaning capacity of commercial bank, is the cash reserve ratio. Yeah, the meaning of the Hindi is Nagat Arakshit Anupat. Cash reserve ratio is a certain percentage of bank deposit which banks are required to kept with RBI. in the form of reserves or balances. Higher the CRR with the RBI, lower will be the liquidity system, and vice versa, RBI is empowered to vary CRR between 15% and 3%. But as per the suggestion by the Narasimhan committee report, the CRR was reduced from 15% in the 1990 to 5% in 2002. As of January 2013, the CRR is 4%. The same factor, as it is a very common factor about the increasing, or the you can say direct relation, indirect relation. If the bank rate is increased, then the loaning capacity of commercial bank reduced. The same thing happened here. If the CRR is increased, the loaning capacity of commercial bank is also reduced, because the CRR is a certain percentage of bank deposit which banks are required to keep with RBI. Wahi same thing, if the CRR increase, agar aapka loading nagad arakshit anupat, that means ek cash ka ek anupat aapko RBI ke paas rakhna hota hai for the part of reserves. Agar CRR badh jata hai, if the CRR is increased, then you have to more cash kept with RBI, and you have only a limited number of amount to loaning in the field of economy. So CRR or cash reserve ratio refers to a portion of deposit as cash which banks have to keep maintained with the RBI. During the inflation, RBI increases the CRR, due to which commercial banks have to keep a greater portion of their deposit. Agar inflation ka daur hai, teji ka daur hai, CRR ko RBI badha deta hai, commercial banks ko jo anupat CRR jo RBI ke paas rakhna hai in the form of cash reserve, वो अनुपात भी बढ़ जाता है और उनके पास लोडिंग कैपेसिटी कम हो जाती है. उनको ज्यादा नगद आरबीआई के पास रिजर्व के तौर में रखा जाता है और कम लिक्विड या लिक्विडिटी उनके पास रह जाती है लोडिंग करने के लिए. आरबीआई ये स्टेप उठाता है टू कंट्रोल द इन्फ्लेशन इन अवर इकोनॉमी. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द मेजर इंस्ट्रूमेंट विच आरबीआई अप्लाइज मैनी ऑफ टाइम्स टू रेगुलेट टू कंट्रोल द इन्फ्लेशन, एंड दिस सर्व्स टू पर्पस. First is ensures that a portion of bank deposit is totally risk free, and secondly it involves that RBI control liquidity in the system and thereby inflation. It ensures that a portion of bank deposit is totally risk free. Suppose, as we discussed in earlier slide, if monetary policy also regulate if the credit goes to productive sector or the productive activity, non to non productivity. If the commercial bank continue loaning in the to public, and the public or the concerned person concerned loan, deposit or the invest to unproductive sectors, so RBI increase the CRR portion, and this is one of the safety measure, ki this the portion is a very safe with RBI. जो नगद है वो बहुत सेफ है, वो अनप्रोडक्टिव सेक्टर में नहीं लग रहा है, जो लोनिंग ज्यादा हो जाती है वो सेफली रिजर्व बैंक के पास है, और जो लोनिंग कैपेसिटी है वो रिड्यूस हो गई है, जिससे कि मनी सप्लाई को कंट्रोल करने में आसानी होती है, और जो प्राइसेस इज विच इज गॉन हाई वो रिड्यूस होना शुरू हो जाती है. हियर इज अ चार्ट, यू कैन से इज द किस तरीके से टाइमलाइन चेंजेस CRR में आ हुए हैं फ्रॉम सिंस 1992. यू कैन लुक ओवर हियर, एंड द सेम थिंग इफ यू कैन लुक द मैक्सिमम CRR इंक्रीज विच यू कैन फाइंड ओवर 10 इन 1997, 10.511 इन 1996, 12 इन 1996 आल्सो. As that is 27th of April is 13.50, and now the maximum, if you can see over chart, is 1992 15% CRR ko kiya gaya tha in 1992. Now is the month of February, you can see is the 4%. If you can focus on slide, you can see the changes of CRR simultaneously in a year, in a couple of in a many times in a single month to regulate the money supply in our economy. If you can look over here, is the 97, 97, 97, 97, the four times in the month 12, 11, 10 and January in a same year. So, if you can look 2013, the CRR is 4%. When the CRR is 11%, you can imagine what is the situation of inflation in our economy. When the CRR goes so high, that it implies that the situation was very in bad condition. जिसको आप तेजी कहते हैं वो क्या स्थिति में होगी अगर CRR 11% है. In previous scenario in 2013, if the CRR is 4%, then we can realize what are the situation we are facing. जब CRR को 4% RBI ने किया है मनी को कंट्रोल करने के लिए, तब we are facing in a inflation scenario. So what was the scene when the inflation goes to 11%? You can imagine. The third one is opaque market operations. What is that opaque market operations? It means that the bank controls the flow of credit through the sale and purchase of securities in the open market operations. When securities are purchased by central bank, then RBI makes payment to commercial banks and public. So the public and commercial bank now have more money with them. It increases money supply with commercial banks and public, and this will expand credit in the economy. In the data of 2012-13, RBI purchases securities 8,000 crore. This is called the open market operations. With the help of, if the market gets fluctuated with inflation, then RBI purchases some types of bond securities by in the scene of inflation, RBI bound to purchase of commercial banks of securities and deposit. Why? Because when the commercial banks bound to purchase from RBI deposit and securities, they will pay some money and they get the document or the paper in the form of securities or bonds, and the money from commercial banks to RBI. So the same thing happened here. The loaning capacity of commercial bank is being reduced. So in the part of inflation, RBI bound to commercial bank to purchase securities and bonds from RBI. In vice versa, in the scene of recession, RBI can purchase commercial banks from commercial banks bond and securities. It's the vice versa. तेजी की स्थिति में आरबीआई कमर्शियल बैंक को बाउंड करता है कि वो सिक्योरिटीज और बॉन्ड्स खरीदे. क्यों? जिससे कि ये जो लिक्विडिटी पार्ट है, जो उनके पास नगद है, वो आरबीआई के पास आ जाए और उनके पास एक डॉक्यूमेंट के तौर पर सिक्योरिटीज और बॉन्ड के जो पेपर्स हैं वो होते हैं, एंड दे आर नॉट टेकिंग और दे आर नॉट रेडी टू मोर लोनिंग बिकॉज दे आर पेइंग सम money to in the form of securities and bond to RBI. In vice versa, recession ke samay mein RBI can purchase and RBI can pay in terms of money or the cash to commercial banks because unki loaning capacity badh jaye. Aur recession ke daur mein jab zarurat hoti hai zyada expenditure karne ki, money kam hoti hai, employment generate nahi ho raha hota hai, to us samay zyada expenditure ki zarurat hoti hai, to RBI can purchase from bond and securities and pay some of the amount to commercial banks because of the loan, because the excise or the increase the loaning capacity of commercial banks. In data figure in 2012-13, RBI purchases securities 8,000 crore. During inflation, as RBI sells securities in the open market, which leads to transfer to money to RBI, thus money supply is controlled in the economy. The fourth one is SLRR. It means a certain percentage of deposit is to be kept by bank in form of liquid asset, and this is kept by bank itself. The liquid assets here include government securities, treasury bills and other securities notified by RBI. And if SLR is more than banks, have to keep more part of deposit in specified securities, and banks will have less surplus funds for granting loans. This is also one instrument to regulate the money supply in our economy, to regulate the inflation in our economy. If SLR is more, then banks have to keep more part of deposit. As the word suggests, कि आपको ज्यादा डिपॉजिट आरबीआई के पास रखना पड़ता है एज पार्ट ऑफ एसएलआर एंड यू योर लोनिंग कैपेसिटी इज बीइंग रिड्यूस इफ द एसएलआर इज इंक्रीज इट विल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट क्रेडिट एसएलआर इज फिक्स्ड बाय आरबीआई एंड यूजली इट हैज बीन रैंकिंग बिटवीन 24% टू 39% नॉट बियॉन्ड दैट द करंट एसएलआर इज 23% And either words, if SLR increase the lending capacity of commercial banks, decreases, thereby regulating the supply of money in the economy. And this is one of the also important factor in part of instruments. But as I said, CRR and bank rate, these are the two very much important factor which the RBI applied so many times in regulate to economy, to control the inflation. To reach the objective of equilibrium. Here you can say in graph ki what is the scene from the 1949 to 2012 of SLR. Here you can look from 1949 SLR is 20 and in the mid of 1993 the SLR is go beyond 37%, but in 2012 it little bit reduced in comparison to previous year, it's 23%. So here you can look at the time of inflation and recession, RBI several times applied the SLR instrument to regulate the inflation and recession scenario and to achieve equilibrium in economy. Some types of indirect instruments are also there to control the loaning capacity of commercial banks, to regulate the money flow in our economy. What is this? This is liquidity adjustment facility, LAF. Consist of daily infusion or absorption of liquidity on a repurchase basis through repo liquidity injection and reverse repo liquidity absorption action operation using government security as collateral. Many of guys, if you read newspapers, these are the two terms which you have seen number of times. In magazines, in newspapers, those who are not the part of economics, they are also aware about the repo rate. They are also aware only for the word repo rate and the reverse repo rate. So many times there are so many times RBI reduces repo rate, reverse repo rate, sometimes increases repo rate and sometimes reverse repo rate. What is this? What is the meaning of repo rate and reverse repo rate? Repo rate is the rate at which RBI lends to commercial banks generally against government securities. Reduction in repo rate helps the commercial bank to get money at a cheaper rate. An increase in repo rate discourages the commercial bank to get money as the rate increase and become expensive. Simple as you seen in the form of bank rate when the commercial bank gets the loan from RBI on rate, but repo rate is a part of securities when RBI lends to commercial banks generally against government securities. Reduction in repo rate, that means it helps to commercial banks to get more money for loaning. When the repo rate decreased, that means there are some recession in our economy. If the repo rate is go below, that you definitely means that our economy is in a little bit recession. And if the repo rate is go high, then it means that our economy is in inflation scene. So reverse repo rate is the rate at which RBI borrows money from the commercial banks, is the reverse repo rate. The increase in the repo rate will increase the cost of borrowing and lending of the banks, which will discourage the public to borrow money and will encourage them to deposit. So, as the rates are high, the availability of credit and demand decreases. And this increase in repo rate and reverse repo rate is a symbol of tightening of the policy. When you ask about the how many types of monetary policy, there are two types. One is soft versus, and the one is tight versus. Normally, when the RBI applied some of the steps to regulate the inflation, then they applied a hard step. And when you can say, when your economy in a recession or the mandi ke daur mein hai, to RBI applied some of the soft steps, sometimes of decrease in cash reserve ratio rate, sometimes of decrease in bank rate, sometimes of decrease in repo and the reverse repo rate. So, it's a very liberal part of our monetary policy if the economy is in recession. But sometimes when the economy is a high inflation, then RBI should apply a very hard steps. So, that's why the monetary policy also an expansion policy and the constructive policy also. Nowadays, the as of August 2013, repo rate is 7.2% and the reverse repo rate is 6.25%. This is the figure of August 2013. When you can see over figure, then you find how the fluctuation goes for the part of repo and reverse repo rate. And you can see there ki reverse repo rate is always below from terms of repo rate. Is the red mark is repo, reverse repo rate, and the blue line is show for repo rate. From November 2008 to May 2030, the fluctuation is on your slide, where you can say from November 2006 reverse repo rate is near about 6, where the repo rate is near about 7.5, not too exact 8, is the 7.5 near about, and now the fluctuation goes a trade cycle view and ups down, and the May 2013 is repo rate is near about a 7 and 6 point something, and the reverse repo is 6 point something, and the repo rate is 7 point something. So this is your figure where you can collect all the data and know how the fluctuation goes. Qualitative measures. अभी हम लोगों ने देखा क्वांटिटेटिव मेजर्स. देर आर फोर मेजर्स, बैंक रेट, एसएलआर, सीआरआर एंड ओपन मार्केट ऑपरेशंस, एंड नाउ वी आर फोकसिंग क्वालिटेटिव मेजर्स, एंड आरबीआई अप्लाई समटाइम्स ऑफ क्वालिटेटिव मेजर्स आल्सो. व्हाट इज क्वालिटेटिव मेजर्स? फर्स्ट वन इज मार्जिन रिक्वायरमेंट्स. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ मार्जिनल मार्जिन रिक्वायरमेंट्स एंड हाउ इज इट नेसेसरी? बेसिकली मार्जिन इज द डिफरेंस between loan value and market value security, and it is fixed by RBI. For different types of loan, margin requirement is different. All of you are heard about the margin word. So for different types of loan, margin requirement is different. If margin percentage is more, then less loan value, your less loan will be given for a certain value of security, and vice versa. Example, if margin requirement is 20%, then bank will give maximum 80% of the market value of security as loan. For priority sector, margin requirement is less, and in areas where credit is to be contracted, margin requirement is increased. Simple. If RBI says that in this sector there is so much need of money flow, when RBI is very much liberal about the margin percentage, because there is so much need of money flow in particular sector, so the margin of loan is below, jisse ki jyada se jyada loaning ho sector ke liye aur usme economic jo activities hain wo regulate ho. But if the RBI when in view that if to be contracted margin requirement in particular sector, then RBI increase the margin ratio of particular loan. If you can see, if for different types of loans, margin requirement is different. It also depends on the loan of which sector. As example, you can see for priority sector, margin requirement is less, and in it, because why? Because priority sector needs a more flow of money. If the margin percentage is go much increase, so it's a dissatisfied scenario of all the lending part of commercial banks, ki they are very much dissatisfied about the margin percentage of priority sector if increased. So for this reason, RBI disclose many of times margin percentage of priority sector is little bit below in terms in comparison to other sector. During inflation, RBI fixes a high rate of margin on the securities kept by the public for loans. If the margin increase, the commercial will bank give less amount of credit. The same policy applied which we discussed earlier slides. If the margin increased, the commercial banks will give less amount of credit, and on the securities kept by the banks and public, thereby controlling inflation. The second one's moral situation. Reserve Bank can also exercise moral influence. Abhi tak aapne dekha quantitative measures, jahan RBI implies kar raha hai. Ye hai aapke qualitative measures, where one of the major is Reserve Bank can also exercise moral influence upon the members of bank with a view to pursue its monetary policy. RBI sometimes holds a meeting with the member of commercial banks and suggest to lend your loan, to lend your commercial loans to productive sector, not to unproductive sector. RBI meetings karta hai, members ko bulata hai commercial banks ki, aur unko ye moral influence deta hai ki aapke bank se jo loan ho raha hai wo productive sector ke liye diya jaye, ya jo productive sector ke liye loans hai usme margin ki percentage kam rakhi jaye. So this is type of moral influence RBI applied time to time. From time to time, Reserve Bank holds meeting with the member banks seeking their cooperation in effective controlling of the monetary system of the country. It advises them to extend more credit to priority sector. There are three sectors in our economy: priority, secondary, and tertiary. And we are aware that priority sector, which is agriculture sector, most of the activities are in agriculture sector, consist in priority sectors. Priority sectors, the range of GDP in terms of service sectors, the secondary sector and the priority sector. Priority sectors, there are so much agriculture activities, fisheries, fisheries, jo chote chote aapke matsya palan jisko bola jata hai, is tarike ki activities aapki priority sectors mein aati hain. And the secondary sectors, jo aapke medium enterprises hain, jo udyog hain, laghu udyog hain, wo aapke secondary hain. And the service sectors, and nowadays service sectors, the role of service sector in our GDP is near about 60%, and the secondary sector is near about 30%, 30 to 35%, but the primary sector goes to near about 10%, the agriculture sector. So the primary sector is more very much needy to get the some fruitful implementation to generate some economic activity in priority sector. And how is it possible? With the help of commercial bank loaning, more and more loaning, more and more developments in for the priority sector very much needful. So that's why it advises with the commercial banks members by Reserve Bank to extend more credit to priority sectors. According to 1914 Act, Reserve Bank can stop any commercial bank from any type of transaction. So direct action, this is the third qualitative measures, direct action. So one of the act here is 1949 act. Reserve Bank can stop any commercial bank from any type of transaction in case of deficiency of the order of Reserve Bank. It can restore to direct action against the member bank. It can stop giving loans and even recommend the closure of the member bank to central government under pressing circumstances. RBI very much not applied for this type of direct action sometimes, but they can apply. RBI can apply anytime. According to 1949 Act, RBI can stop any commercial bank. किसी भी कॉमर्शियल बैंक की एक्टिविटी को आरबीआई इस एक्ट के तहत रोक सकता है, बंद कर सकता है, किसी भी तरीके के ट्रांजेक्शन को बंद कर सकता है इफ द कॉमर्शियल बैंक इज नॉट ओबेइंग हिज लॉस. व्हाट आर द आरबीआई सजेस्टेड इन मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी? इफ द कॉमर्शियल बैंक इज नॉट फॉलोइंग द मेजर्स ऑफ द मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी विच इज आरबीआई लॉन्च्ड, इफ द आरबीआई इज नॉट सेटिस्फाइड विद द स्टेप्स ऑफ कॉमर्शियल बैंक, आरबीआई कैन स्टॉप any commercial bank for any type of transaction according to 1949 Act. Credit ceiling, the last one measures. In this operation, RBI issues prior information or the direction that loans to the commercial bank will be given up to a certain limit. In this case, commercial bank will be tight in advancing loans to the public. They will allocate loans to limited sector. Few example of ceiling are agriculture sector advances and the prior sector lending. RBI also operates the credit ceiling in terms of qualitative measures. RBI asks to commercial banks that they have to loan only for prior sector advances or agriculture sector advances. RBI directly says, directly ceiling the credit and ask the commercial bank that you have to apply more credit, you have to give more credit loans to agriculture sector and you have to less loans to particular sector if the RBI pointed out the any one of the sector there is no need of money flow, then RBI stop or the reduce the loaning capacity of commercial bank or directly ask to please stop or the reduce the loaning loaning or the lending of loans of particular sector. And here is chart how the monetary policy formulate. This is the chart, you can look over here. Monetary policy kis tarike se form hoti hai, kis tarike se board members, kis tarike se central board of directors, reviewers, jo aap monetary policy saal ke do baar aap dekhte hain, uska review, uska formulation kis tarike se hota hai, kya process hota hai. You can see from the top to bottom, monetary policy a completed and participated process. सभी का रोल रहता है इसमें, मार्केट के अलावा फाइनेंशियल मार्केट, रिव्यूज, मैनेजेस, एनालिसिस, और इस चैनल के थ्रू द मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी इज फॉर्म. एंड हाउ दस मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी अफेक्ट्स इन्फ्लेशन एंड अदर प्रॉब्लम्स. आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड इफ यू कैन सी ओवर हियर, देन यू आर अवेयर इन अ सिंगल ग्लांस that if the recession and unemployment measures, central bank buys securities through open market operation, it reduces CRR, it lowers bank rate in form of recession, mandi ke samay mein. Kis tarike se arrow se aap dekh sakte hain ki money supply increase, interest rate falls, investment falls, aggregate demand increase, aggregate output increase. Agar ye cheeze hoti hain, central banks buy securities through open market operation, it reduces CRR, इट लोअर बैंक रेट, क्या होगा? मनी सप्लाई इंक्रीजेस, इंटरेस्ट रेट फॉल्स, इन्वेस्टमेंट फॉल्स, एग्रीगेट डिमांड इंक्रीजेस, एग्रीगेट आउटपुट इंक्रीजेस. इन द कॉन्ट्रैक्टरी मनी, ये कहलाती है आपकी एक्सपेंसरी मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी एज वी डिस्कस. द सेकेंड टर्म्स इज कॉन्ट्रैक्शनरी मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी व्हेन अप्लाइड इन द टाइम ऑफ इन्फ्लेशन. क्या मेजर्स होते हैं? सेंट्रल बैंक सेल्स सिक्योरिटीज, इधर वो बाय कर रहा है, इधर सेल कर रहा है. बाय कर रहा है डेट मींस आरबीआई गिविंग सम मनी टू कमर्शियल बैंक्स टू लैंडिंग लोन्स बिकॉज ऑफ रिसेशन और मंदी. द सेकंड टर्म्स इन द टर्म्स ऑफ इन्फ्लेशन आर सेंट्रल बैंक सेल सिक्योरिटीज, बेच रहा है कमर्शियल बैंक्स को. व्हाई? द कमर्शियल बैंक पेइंग टू सम मनी टू आरबीआई टू रिड्यूस द मनी फ्लो इन मार्केट. Factor affecting monetary policy are, there are exist non-monetarized sector, excess of non-banking financial institutions, excess of unorganized financial, this is the one very interesting factor, unorganized financial market. Bank अपनी सारी activities कर रहा है money flow को control करने के लिए, but there are some unorganized sectors, जिसको आप साहूकार कहते हैं, कहीं आपने loan, कहीं आपने पैसा ब्याज पे ले लिया है, and वो है तो money, और वो money आपने जब unorganized sector से ली है, और वो फ्लो कर रही है मार्केट में, तो इन्फ्लेशन को कंट्रोल होने में थोड़ा वक्त लग जाता है और थोड़ा प्रॉब्लम आती है, बिकॉज द लैंडिंग ऑफ पर्टिकुलर लोन इज नॉट फ्रॉम द ऑर्गेनाइज्ड सेक्टर, इज कम फ्रॉम अनऑर्गेनाइज्ड फाइनेंशियल सेक्टर. तो पॉलिसी जो सरकार की होती है, जो ये जो आपने इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स देखे वो ऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर तक तो काम कर रहे हैं, पर वैन यू टेक द लोन फ्रॉम अनऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर एंड यू इन्वेस्ट सम अनप्रोडक्टिव और द मार्केट, then how can government know ki why the inflation is so much raising, even RBI implies or the applied so many instrument. This is the cause, the because the money came from unorganized financial sector. So there are time lag effect success to monetary policy. Monetary policy and physical policy lacks coordination. Here are look of physical policy. What is the meaning of physical policy? Physical policy has to decide on size and pattern of flow expenditure from the government to the economy and from the economy back to government. So the physical policy is concerned with the raising of government revenue and incurring of government expenditure to generate revenue and to incur expenditure. One of the Kaushik Basu, former chief economic advisor, said about the physical policy that deals with the taxation and expenditure decision of the government. Physical policy, there are three types of mainly a possible position. One is neutral position, expansionary position is where there is a higher budget deficit, where the government is spending higher than the revenue. And contractionary position is when the lower budget deficit, where the government is spending is lower than the revenue collected from the tax. Instrument of physical policy, there are four instruments: public expenditure, taxation, public debt, deficit financing. And these are also used to regulate our economy or the money flow of our economy. And how is it regulated? In the form of public expenditure. When you are part of inflation, public expenditure is an important component of aggregate demand. When you are part in recession, therefore excess demand can be corrected by reducing government expenditure. Reduction in government expenditure also leads to decline in the volume of national income. On the other hand, government should increase expenditure on public works programs such as the construction of roads, expansion of railways. When you are in economy in recession mode, then the government applies this step. Kya step hai? On the other hand, government should increase expenditure. Jab aap mandi ke daur mein hai, to government increase kar deti hai expenditure, jisse ki employment generate ho, logon ko rozgar mile, logon ko suvidhaye mile. So they increase government expenditure in the form of public roads, expansions of railways, setting up power projects and something else. The other is taxation policy. The second one is taxation. Taxes are the main source of revenue of government, and government levies both the direct and indirect taxes. Sometimes we are not aware about the indirect taxes. We are paying indirect taxes and we are not aware that we have already paid. Sometimes if you can purchase a good which is MRP is 49 rupees, then you are indirectly pay near about the 14 to 17% tax actual cost of the particular product, but you are not aware that you have already paid for this. Agar aapka 49 MRP hai aur aap pay kar rahe hain usko, indirectly aap uska tax bhi pay kar de rahe hain jo usme MRP mein include hai. And the direct taxes are income tax, wealth tax, some of the tax of in the form of indirect tax, these are custom duties, VAT. And the main objective of taxation policy are to promote saving, to promote equality of income and wealth. Public debt, government needs to lots of funds for economic development of the country. No government can mobilize so much funds by way of tax. And here is some data of public debt. As on 31st March of 2013, external debit and internal debit are here. And 31st March of 2015, the data is over your slide. And this is deficit financing. This is the one the last instrument of physical policy, and this is physical policy 2013-14. And what is the difference between is the monetary policy is the process by which the monetary authority of a country, and here is review Subba Rao, former RBI governor, and but what they suggest. So this is your microeconomic series of the monetary and the physical policy.
Many thank you, sir, for starting our series and also bringing it to a wonderful conclusion today. And with this, I'd like to tell our viewers that after this, I will be beginning a series on microeconomics. So stay tuned in for that. Thank you so much, sir, and thank you, viewers, for watching.
Thank you.